folks, today we're going to take it back a little bit old school. We're going to do some JT. We're going to do some Cry Me a River, classic Justin Timberlake tune. We're going to have two little parts to it. We're going to have the main riff, which you had me playing just at the start there, which has four chords in it, and then you've got the little sort of synthy part that goes over the top as well. So we're going to have two parts to learn. So let's get started with it. Right, folks, we're in standard tuning. There's four chords altogether. We have E minor. You can see the shape on the screen right now. We have B7. We have C. We have A minor 6. Okay, so let's go through the shapes. Our capo is at the 4th fret. Our E minor is a standard E minor chord using two fingers. And we've got the pinky added in at the 3rd fret on the 1st string there. Remember, 3rd fret from the capo. What we're going to do is we're going to play with our fingers. You can use a pick for this, but I prefer the sound of the fingers. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to pick the thumb on the 6th string. And then we're going to pick the 4th string with the thumb. Then we're going to use one finger at a time to go down 3, 2 and 1. Okay, so that's index finger on the 3rd string, middle finger on the 2nd string and 3rd finger on the 1st string. So that will give us 5 notes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all together, okay? String wise, that's 6, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, and that'll give us our first part. So that's E minor. Now to make our B7 shape, be quite good with a bar chord for this, okay? So our bar is happening with our first finger. We're barring down over the strings from the 5th to the 1st string, and then we're playing our 3rd finger, replacing that at the 4th fret on the 4th string, and our pinky is getting placed at the 4th fret on the 2nd string. If we strum that down from string number 5, you're going to get the sound of the song. Pick wise here, we'll be using thumb for two strings on strings 5 and 4. So we moved the root note from the 6th string down to the 5th string now. Played 5 and 4 with the thumb, then 3, 2, 1 with index, middle and then 3rd. Okay, so that'll give us, that's our second chord, our B7. Then we've got C, which is probably the hardest one of them all. We're going to be playing our index finger, once again, a bar from 5 to 1, just one fret ahead of where you were. That's going to be at the 3rd fret. Then we're going to place our 3rd finger and bar it over 3 strings. The 3 strings are strings 4, 3 and 2, and they're at the 5th fret from the capo. Now we're going to play the same strings played down like this, but what you'll find is this finger has to arch in a kind of awkward way. We have to push the knuckle in the way like that, okay, instead of out the way, because if we push it out the way like so, it's not going to give us enough pressure on the string, so we have to push closely into it. There's also a way of playing this chord using all 3 fingers, and that's a bit awkward for me because my fingers are quite big, so that would be playing like an A chord, just a normal A chord, and sliding it along 3 frets and then making the bar behind it. So you can experiment with this one. This is the hardest chord of them all. But we're going for strings 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Again, thumb, index, middle, and 3rd on that chord. Going back to our last one, this is our A minor, with our 6th added in over the top. We're going to be playing the same strings, okay? So A minor, you should know. See that shape there? We're just adding in a pinky at the 2nd fret on the 1st string, and we're going to be playing strings 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Same pattern, thumb, index, middle, 3rd. Okay, so let's play it all the way through. We'll play it through nice and slow, and you can hear how the chords fit together. So here we go. So here's E minor, then B7, then C, and A minor 6. Okay, what you're going to try and do is make it kind of snappy. So as soon as you play that first chord, you're going to get rid of the sound and then move to the next one. Okay, so we're going to put rests in between those chords, make it sound nice and snappy. Okay, so that's our first part done. And now we'll move on to our little riff that goes over the top of this. Right, our little riff that goes over the top of this is just a single note melody. Yeah, we'll put the tab up on the screen right now so you can see what it looks like. You can see we're just playing basically 3 strings, 4, 3 and 2, and we're playing a selection of 2nd frets, 4th frets, opens and 1sts. So, first thing we're going to do is take the second fret on the fourth string, and we're using our index finger, and we're going to walk along 2 and 4. So that's second fret with the index, fourth fret, third finger, and then we're going to go down a string and play 0, 2 and 4 on the third string. So that's two notes on the D, our fourth string, and then two notes on the G, which is our third string. Then you're going to do a pause. Then we're going to go down to the first fret on the second string and play 1 and then 0. And then we're going to play the second fret above that on the third string. So that's 1, 0 on the second fret, sorry, second string, and then second fret on the third string. Rest again, then you'll do it again. And then once more, same thing. And then we're going to go to the fifth fret from the capo, and that's on the second string, and you're going to put a little bit of vibrato on that. So you're going to shake the string. Okay, so we'll put that all together. Do it nice and slow to start off with. Okay, so we had it slow and then fast. You can see it's quite a simple little riff, but when coupled with those chords, so you have someone to play along with, or if you're playing along with the song, it's useful to try out those riffs along with it. So that first one here, try that over the song, and then also go back and try. They sound absolutely great together. Okay, so that's the two parts to the song. Hope you found it useful. Thanks for watching, folks. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, remember to rate, comment and subscribe. You can go and check out the Facebook page where you can make requests as well. I'll leave the link in the description below. And until the next lesson, take care.